If you've ever changed the TV remote batteries because the TV wasn't coming on, or if you old school like me, if you had to blow in them game cartridges to get the video game to work, or if you just simply reset your Wi-Fi router because your internet wasn't coming on. These are all examples of using the power of troubleshooting and having a troubleshooting skill. Because troubleshooting is nothing more than just the intersection of your knowledge and your experience and where it meets up with a particular specific circumstance at a specific time and place. Like that example of the Wi-Fi going out, that you have knowledge, right? That's your knowledge and your experience with Wi-Fi and your Wi-Fi router. That's what gives you the Wi-Fi service. That's how you get connected to the Wi-Fi and then ultimately get connected to the internet. And then the specific circumstance or at the time and place is just when the internet goes out. So you use your troubleshooting skills if the internet goes out. You don't immediately just hop on a call with your ISP because you already know what time it is. You're going to say, did you power cycle a router? And even before you even get that far, because that's really like last resort if you got to jump on with your ISP. Usually before that even happens, you're going to do things like refresh your browser or maybe try a different device to see if it's just your phone might be messing up. Maybe your phone needs to get reset or something, or needs to do an update or whatever. Or you might just try power cycling the router just off rip, you just want to reset it and just to get it going. So if you're interested or you just want resource or a guide to help you build that skill, or just like having a reference, then this video is definitely going to be for you. Also, if you want to see more similar content like this, because I'm going to be posting videos every week, if you don't know, definitely go ahead and tap that like button. Go ahead and click that subscribe to the channel and everything. So the first tip that I want to share for troubleshooting is commonalities. Basically, just finding out what's in common with whatever kind of issue you're trying to troubleshoot. So for networking specifically, right? Because that's where my bread and butter, that's where my experience lies. So if you're troubleshooting networking issues, you want to look for common things like the subnet. Is the issue occurring on the same subnet, or is it occurring across different kind of subnets throughout your network? Whatever the issue may be, whether it's intermittent connectivity or just pure connectivity issues or slowness or latency or whatever, if that's occurring on your network, you want to see what's in common with this issue. Is it the subnets? If you're dealing with a specific location, just like one subnet, is it happening everywhere in that building or that location? Or is it just happening sporadically throughout different parts of that site? Is it on the first floor? Is it happening on the second floor? This is just going to help you isolate it, just finding issues that are in common. Also, like specific devices, are like scan guns the only thing getting affected? Can you use the network services on a mobile phone, or is it just specific laptops? What's in common with those laptops? Do they all need to get re-imaged? When's the last time they had an update, or anything, any kind of common things? That's all you're trying to search for. This is just going to help you isolate the issue. Again, I'm not going to know every scenario that you're going to come across, but this is just a strategy, just a general guideline that I use, because every situation, and that's what I love about this field and everything, every day is going to be different. So of course, some days it's going to start being like the mundane stuff where you start getting into just regular stuff, but right when it starts getting like that, just know that right around the corner, there's going to be a time where something's just going to come out of nowhere and you're going to have to put on that thinking cap. And this is just one of the strategies that you can use, just finding the commonalities, just common things that are happening according to your specific issue. Up next, we're going to talk about the second thing for your troubleshooting strategy or how to build this skill. And this is called known good devices. This is what I'm gonna call this one, just known good devices. And this reminds me of that Sesame Street song where they taught you like one of those things is not like the other. If you can remember that song, right? Where they matched up like four things, right? But just one of them was not matched up with all of the rest of them, and you had to describe it or whatever, figure out what was different between the one item versus the rest of the three items in that whole collective there. So that's kind of the same concept with a known good device. If I get an issue and let's say, for example, they're like, Wi-Fi isn't working, right? And they're saying that it's only happening on one specific device, right? So we're just gonna start looking at different things like, okay, so if it's, let's say PCs, where is the known good device? Is there a PC that will connect to the Wi-Fi in that specific area of your location, of your building or whatever? Oh yeah, I got a PC. Okay, now I got something that's a known good. We know that the Wi-Fi is working. It's just one of these PCs isn't working. So if I get another PC and they got other PCs and just every other PC is working except for this one, then we could start isolating and troubleshooting stuff. Maybe the operating system needs to get reinstalled, or we could start looking at the drivers for the Wi-Fi. Maybe, it, depending on what the situation is, can it even see a SSID with the wireless NIC that that specific device is using? Or it can't even see the SSID, then we know, okay, let's start looking at the drivers and stuff and replacing that or whatever. Or have we tried rebooting this PC and all the other PCs have been rebooted? You're just trying to find out what is different about this specific device versus a known good device. And it's always good to just have a known good, whatever the case may be. Even if it's a known good piece of networking equipment and this switch is failing, but this switch is working. What has happened to this switch? Does this switch need an iOS upgrade? Is the CPU utilization being overused on this switch? Again, every scenario is going to be different, but it's always good to just find what a known good is and just work off of that. That's usually what I try to do, is there, because this network has been set up and it's been working fine up until the day when y'all decide to call me or whatever. Or sometimes you'll find that people let issues go on for months and months and then they want to decide to call you. So that's a whole nother story for a whole nother video. But what I'm saying is just try to find like what a known good device on the network is, and then just start comparing things and trying to figure stuff out that way, because it just helps out. Because if you know that one device is working good, then it's just really isolating that issue, and you can just quickly get to an answer, a resolution, or at least just isolate it to just that device and say, hey, we just need to replace this device with something else because this one just isn't working. Whatever the case may be, it just helps you out that much better. And it's just like a simple strategy, and it's not going to get you the answer all the time, but at least instead of you just troubleshooting randomly or not having any kind of strategy or anything and just sitting there gathering information and you don't know what to do with all of this information that you gathered, because that's part of troubleshooting. Once you gather information, you got to put it through an analysis, that information that you've gathered. You got to analyze that data. And if you don't have a strategy to analyze that data, like finding commonalities about your issue or finding a known good device, these are just some tips that really have helped me out in the past. Finally, the third tip or the third troubleshooting strategy I use is divide and conquer. And as a beginner, you'll find that this is one that you're probably already doing, or that you will just naturally fall into using this strategy if you just start out, if you're not even in the field yet. When you get in the field, you're probably going to just start using this one. And the reason why, because this is mostly everybody's favorite, and the reason why is because it works with like the least amount of information, right? Because for this one, you pretty much just need an IP address. So divide and conquer just means what you're going to do is, let's say you have a connectivity issue, you're going to just automatically get the IP address of whatever you're having a connectivity issue, and you're going to just try to ping it. And if ping works, then you know you could divide that, right? That you know pretty certain, or you're pretty certain or pretty confident that your physical layer and your data link layer are good if ping is working, right? But if you still can't connect, At least you've divided those pieces up. So if you still can't connect, but ping is working, but they're still having whatever kind of issues, now you're just gonna be something on the higher level, right? This could be stuff like authentication, or it could be things like specific issues with the applications or whatever. Maybe it's not listening on the right TCP port or something if you're trying to communicate with a server. Those are things that you can isolate because you've divided, and now you're just gonna go ahead and conquer by isolating more to a specific application issue, or just really isolating to something higher than IP or layer 3. Now, if your ping fails, now you know, okay, now you could divide that up to where you don't even have to look at these higher layer things like authentication or whatever, all these higher level issues. You could start looking lower level stuff, things below ping or below layer 3, like your data link layer. Is it one device or many devices affected? Or the physical layer, does the device even have power that you're trying to ping to? Is there a cable an issue with it? Is the NIC something wrong with the NIC? All these physical layer kind of issues. That's how you can divide and conquer that way if your ping is not working. All right, my ninjas, that's gonna wrap it up pretty much for this one. I just wanted to get on here real quick because I'm just realizing that, yeah, it's important to have that CCNA knowledge, but again, it's really important to be able to troubleshoot. And I just wanted to provide some quick tips to give you some kind of strategy to where you can go in there and you can start to build on it, build your own strategies and methodologies and all of that kind of stuff, so you can start to skill up. That way you can put yourself in the best position possible to be the best, you know, version of yourself if you're just starting out, or if you're already working in the field as a beginner. So let me leave you also right now with a quote that I think related a lot to this whole topic that I learned from Nikola Tesla, right? And this quote says that you can think deeply and be insane, but to be sane, you have to think clearly. So it kind of relates, right? Because you could sit here and you could be thinking about an issue as deep as you want to, researching all of these kind of things and just driving yourself absolutely crazy trying to resolve an issue. Or you can develop a strategy or methodologies and have a systematic approach to troubleshooting any kind of networking issue or IT issue that you have. And that way you can think clearly about it and just be able to isolate or resolve your issue more quickly and efficiently by just having a plan, instead of just driving yourself crazy and just troubleshooting aimlessly. Or that's not even troubleshooting, you're just trying to throw stuff at a wall and see what kind of stuff sticks. It just doesn't look professional to your employer and to your peers and everything. You want to be professional when you're trying to do this stuff. So putting together your own little plan, and you're going to work out your own little kind of plan when you get into this stuff, when you start working and gaining experience and coming across all these kind of issues. Again, if it did, you already know, go on and tap that like button for me, subscribe to the channel so you get more kind of similar content like this, and you already know it's gonna help me in the algorithms and all that there, and definitely share it. I'm gonna holla at y'all on that next video. Peace.